In this video, we're looking at a Carnot heat pump. So similar to another video where it's a Carnot heat engine, but now we're running this cycle, this Carnot cycle, in the reverse direction so that we add work to the system. And that allows us to transfer heat from some low temperature reservoir to one at high temperature. In this case, we're going to run the cycle so that the low temperature in the cycle is 250 and the high temperature is 300, and we're assuming we added 500 joules. So delta S for our engine is zero. This engine that's running around in cycles, because we keep getting back to the same point, we run through another cycle, we end up exactly where we started from, state function. We can't have changed the entropy of this system. And so delta S for that engine is zero, and that's because of the cycle. So that means QH over TH plus QC over TC must equal zero for this system. And so QH over 300 plus QC over 250 is equal to zero. Of course, QC is going to be positive, right? This term is going to be positive because we're adding energy. And QH is going to be negative because we're taking energy away from this system. So that's entropy, the second law. We can also apply the first law to this system, which is just that QH plus QC plus W is zero, just doing an energy balance around this cycle. QH plus QC and then plus W, 500 joules is zero. W is positive, we're adding energy to the system. So I can write QH is equal to minus QC plus 500. So I can substitute that back into here. Minus QC plus 500 over 300 plus QC over 250. This equals zero. And so I've just rearranged this and we can solve this for QC. 2490 joules. That means we can also calculate QH is minus 2490 plus 500, so 2990 joules. When we're running this as a heat pump, a refrigerator, we can talk about, for a refrigerator, a coefficient of performance. So instead of talking about efficiency, we talk about a coefficient of performance, which is QC over W. In this case, this is what we're getting out. This is desired. This is what we're putting in. That's what we have to pay for, if you like. In this case, 2490 over 500, that's about 5. So with 500 joules of work, we can transfer 2,490 joules of heat out of something. In other words, we can, if this is our freezer, in our refrigerator, and we're removing 2,490 joules by putting in with electricity just 500 joules. In the back of the refrigerator, we're rejecting almost 3,000 joules. The other way that a Carnot cycle can be used is to use it as a heat pump, for example, to heat a house. Now, of course, the Carnot cycle is an ideal process, but there are real heat pumps that use the same general idea of adding work and transferring heat from low temperature to high temperature. Now we add 500 joules as work and we get 2990 joules of heat, for example, to heat a room. So with 500 joules of electricity, we would get almost 3,000 joules of heat, a factor of 6, a rather dramatic multiplying factor. Whereas if this 500 joules was added to just a resistive heater, for example, 500 joules of work would give us 500 joules of heat. But this then is a very efficient way to heat a building by taking advantage of a cycle. So instead of a Carnot cycle, of course, it can be a real cycle, and there are indeed commercial heat pumps that take advantage of this idea. And here we're just looking at what's the best we can do. Right, the Carnot cycle, this is ideal, gives an idea what's the best between TC and TH.